Oh yeah.
Oh, I think you're too big. I think that goes all the way through to the other street. If I move this cart, you could walk up its shadow, couldn't you? See you at the ghost now! They haven't started the show yet. You missed the dancers. They were so beautiful. I want to be a dancer when I grow up. Or an acrobat, like you. Did you always want to be an acrobat? Come on, let's go in.
Come on, sugar. Help a girl out here. We can't play in the dark. Hey, one's on the fritz. Hey, Sparky, could you do something about that one, too? It's really messing with our living.
But now I know you love me mostly. Sorry, Joe. You ain't a lover, you're a house on fire. I'm burning so. You hear that siren call, baby? I gotta go. You're in my past, Joe. I had my fill. It couldn't last, Joe. Baby, I got this. There's no one happy in a house on fire. Why do I steal? Hear those sirens going, baby. I need a chill. I got a thrill, babe, and I wanna run back. But I know I gotta hit
vamp for me, Charlie, would ya?
Single word, and
Peggy 18.
All devs are gamers.
I like the fact that Sony has gone back to the fundamentals of, no, it's for games.
I feel extraordinarily lucky
that, you know, day to day, I get to make games for a living.
They allow us to flex our imagination.
And I think makes gaming so powerful.
I want everyone to be able to feel creative and not be intimidated by that.
We suddenly have, like, breathed life into this magical world.
This is what PlayStation is about. It's about innovation and it's about new ideas.
We obviously make the game for the gamer, but at the end of the day, the gamer is us.
I find it really exciting, and I'm glad to be a gamer now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jim Ryan.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome. We were absolutely delighted to open this year's show with the global unveil of the PlayStation 4 user interface. And it was the one and only Shu Yoshida, president of our worldwide studios, who introduced the UI, and who also gave you some great examples of the connected social experience that lies at the heart of PlayStation 4. So a big hand for Shu Yoshida, ladies and gentlemen. But I wanted to start by saying what an honor it is to be here in Cologne tonight. At PlayStation, we've always understood the importance of Europe and the European gamer. And over the 12 years that we've been doing Gamescom press briefings, I've been really proud to watch Gamescom develop from a local consumer event for the German market into a key cornerstone of the global gaming calendar. So let's start with PS3. For a platform in its eighth year, the roster of exclusive games is just stunning. And if you're talking about the games that define PlayStation, where else to start but with Polyphony Digital and Gran Turismo? Everyone knows Polyphony has always been at the cutting edge of creating truly great driving simulators. With that in mind, I'd like to kick off today's presentation with a brand new Gran Turismo 6 video, Vision GT, a project between Polyphony and the key brands. It was Oscar Wilde who said that life imitates art more than art imitates life. And these car manufacturers are utilizing the GT physics engine to create concept vehicles in collaboration with Polyphony Digital. These concept vehicles will appear exclusively in GT6, and in some cases, a real-world version of these concept cars will be created by the manufacturer. Let's take a look.
Oh,
So it's a real pleasure to have a number of our automotive partners here in the audience today, but a particularly warm welcome to the creator of Gran Turismo, Kazunori Yamauchi. With Kazunori here today, it's a great opportunity to confirm what you just saw. The GT6 will launch globally on PS3 on December the 6th this year. And based on Kazunori's amazing vision, I'm pleased to announce that he and Sony Pictures are currently developing a full-length feature film inspired by the GT franchise. In addition to capturing the adrenaline of the racing world, the film's human dimension will be inspired by GT Academy. The Gran Turismo film will be brought to you by two of Hollywood's most respected producers, Michael De Luca and Donna Brunetti. But of course, GT6 is only part of the PS3 story in 2013. We've been really proud of the innovation in new IP that we've brought to the platform in its eighth year. Whether it's the stunningly successful and critically acclaimed The Last of Us from Naughty Dog, or Beyond Two Souls from Quantic Dream, the interactive drama featuring Ellen Page and Willem Dafoe, PlayStation continues to demonstrate its lasting commitment to the PS3 gamer. But when we talk about innovation in PS3, it's not just about new IP. Little Big Planet has fast become one of PlayStation's best-loved and most iconic franchises, with millions of consumers enjoying millions of community creative levels. We're very pleased to announce today that Little Big Planet Hub, a new free-to-play service for PlayStation 3, will launch later this year.
Imagine if we gave you something free to play with and dropped in a bunch of like-minded chums. In fact, imagine a whole community of happy little sack chums. Imagine if we gave you instant access to a continuous supply of wonderful things to do and let you buy other fun stuff at the touch of a button. Imagine if you had access to a jam-packed wardrobe filled to the brim with costumes and accessories where you could create a whole new you and then share your favorite ensembles with your friends or even choose to buy them there and then. Imagine if you could compete in exciting challenges to win magnificent and positively majestic prizes or even set your very own challenges for other sack chums to play. Imagine if we gave you a truckload of tools so that you could make your own levels and games, and then you could share your wonderful creations with the rest of the world. Imagine that. Well, you don't have to imagine at all, because we've crafted and crammed all of these fun features into one little package and made it completely accessible for everyone. How exciting! And what do we call this magical world of wonderment? We call it the Little Big Planet Hub. Perfect.
And finally, 2013 sees the return of Grand Theft Auto to the PlayStation 3. GTA 5 launches on September 17th. And I'm pleased to announce, as part of the partnership with Rockstar Games on GTA 5, we will be introducing from launch a PS3 hardware bundle and a custom-designed Pulse Elite headset. Both the hardware bundle and the headset are exclusive to PlayStation. And, starting on Friday, any PS3 gamer who pre-orders GTA 5 from the PlayStation Store will receive 75% off any Rockstar title in addition to the pre-order DLC. We have all these great PS3 games available for you to play on our stand here at Gamescom, and I really urge you to go check them out. Moving now to PlayStation Vita. A little over a year after launch, consumers can access over 900 games for the platform, of which almost 150 were built from the ground up for PlayStation Vita. It's this breadth and depth of catalog that has allowed us to introduce the PlayStation Megapack range to the European market. offering a themed range of Vita content. Each mega pack includes between 6 and 10 games and provides an affordable point of access to PS Vita. I'm pleased to announce today 3 new mega packs for the European market. Retailing at €35, mega packs are available as standalone software with an 8 gig memory card or as part of a hardware bundle. But let's talk now about what's coming in the future for PlayStation Vita. From third parties in coming months, we have Batman Arkham Origins Blackgate from Warner Brothers, bringing legendary characters from the Arkham universe to a portable platform for the first time. Also from Warner Brothers, LEGO Marvel, featuring over 150 characters from the Marvel universe. Football Manager from Sega, offering the PC classic mode for the first time on a portable device. And finally, Borderlands 2 from 2K. The first-person role-playing... The first-person role-playing shooter that ushered in a new era of loot and shoot when it released last year. It will be making its portable debut on PlayStation Vita. We always knew PS Vita was a developer-friendly device, but we've been really taken aback by the way that the indie development community has embraced the platform. PlayStation's commitment to the indie sector has been firm and consistent. And to demonstrate that commitment, I'm pleased to announce that the highly anticipated Starbound from Chucklefish, the smash hit Fez from Phil Fish, and the sequel to one of the most highly rated shooters of all time, Velocity 2X from Future Lab, will all be coming to PS Vita and PS4 this year. These are but 3 from a long list of indie games heading for PS Vita, and watch this space for more on the Vita indie story. On PlayStation Vita, our goal is to broaden its appeal and to make ownership as accessible as possible. I'm therefore pleased to announce that as of tomorrow, the RRP of PS Vita will be €199 in Europe and $199 in North America. And we will, at the same time, make significant reductions in the price of PS Vita memory cards in both regions. And with that, I'll hand over to Michael Denny, Senior Vice President of our European Studios, to take you through some of the great first-party games that we have coming on PlayStation Vita.
Thanks, Jim, and thank you, everyone. Last year, here at Gamescom, I had the privilege of announcing 5 brand new IPs. Our worldwide studios were committed to producing new IPs to ensure new experiences for all our gamers. This year, I'm excited to be able to continue that theme by introducing 7 more new and exclusive PlayStation titles. Last year, Vita took center stage, showcasing how developers are using Vita's innovative feature set to push the boundaries of portable gaming. In particular, we were proud to unveil Killzone Mercenary, which demonstrates Vita's ability to deliver a first-person shooter with true home console quality graphics and gameplay. Also, the incredibly tactile and charming Tearaway from Media Molecule, which deservedly won the Critics' Choice Award for Best Handheld Game at E3. And we will continue to expand our varied library of games for Vita by exploring new and diverse experiences. At Worldwide Studios, we pride ourselves on working with the most creative talent from around the world. So we were delighted when we had the opportunity to meet with startup Italian developer Oversonico, led by talented industry veterans Massimo Guarini and Gianni Ricciardi. It's my privilege to announce Oversonico's first title, Murasaki Baby. The game is specifically designed around the Vita touch controlled. It's an intensely emotional and tactile experience where you take your character by the hand, navigating the perils of a nightmare fantasy world. Let's take a look.
Thank you.
Thank you. And now for something completely different. We all love music, and music festivals are playing an ever-increasing role in the way many of us choose to experience our favorite performers. Taking inspiration from these festivals, I would like to introduce a new free-to-play game called Big Fest. In Big Fest, you create, build, and manage the ultimate music festival with the goal of becoming the world's greatest music promoter. We partnered with online music portal Jamendo to bring real-world unsigned bands to your festival stages. Players have the chance to discover and promote the world's next big supergroup within the game. And who knows, maybe help them on their way to real-world stardom. Thank you. So new games like Big Fest and Murasaki Baby further demonstrate how we will continue to encourage our developers to bring their new ideas to life, helping to ensure that PlayStation fans will continue to taste a wide variety of new and innovative experiences. And it's not just WWS teams that are finding Vita a great platform on which to bring their ideas to life. As Jim mentioned earlier, the indie community has also embraced Vita, which will ensure an ever-growing library of new experiences for portable gaming fans everywhere. Let's take a look at why the indie community is so excited by Vita.
There's an amazing ecosystem of developers, of creativity, of just inspiration right now coming out of the PlayStation camp. People are just flocking to PlayStation because they see an easy path to get their idea in front of gamers. And so it's just attracting a lot of attention, a lot of excitement, a lot of passion. And this is where things are happening right now.
With some mobile platforms, you know, we had to like make concessions to really awful phones out there. And making games for the Vita is just so much easier, where we know exactly what's going on with them. Super easy and wonderful.
The Vita is a wonderful device that really fills a gap in the handheld market. It has a whole ton of stuff behind the scenes that really lets you do other crazy stuff that you wouldn't normally be able to do.
I like the idea of a dedicated device. As a gamer, I just like that the PlayStation Vita isn't trying to be anything else. It means that I can create very complex interactions and a lot of depth to the game. And then all the network stuff allows me to allow players to share stuff and build stuff together, which is very cool.
The PlayStation Vita has all kinds of features that sort of enhance the experience. The multiplayer is a great way to just have fun with friends, where each person who's playing has control of their own screen. Playing on Vita is one of the like main ways for me to play now. Just lying in my bed with a screen, you know, right here, and it just feels great.
We looked at the Vita and thought, what can we do to make this device sing? Tuning the controls to feel as silky smooth as possible. And that's what Velocity is all about. It's about the feel of the game and mastering those mechanics.
It's a great fit for our game because we have lots of real-time shadows, which requires
quite a lot of visual processing. When you combine the beautiful shadows that we've got with the crisp screen that the Vita's got, then you've got this incredibly beautiful thing that just begs to be played.
Something about that screen that just makes it look so special. And to us, to see the amount of love and work and dedication poured into this game on that Vita screen, it's just the best way for us to show the game. It just seems like it just comes to life there.
As an indie, there's a fear that you're not interesting to a console manufacturer, because we make little games with a kind of a very niche audience. But Sony realized that we can actually target our audience, and we can bring out games that do pretty well on the platform, and that we have a value in doing so.
Well, I think it's obvious that the Sony team have got a great passion for games, and this isn't something that they've just discovered. They've always been passionate. They want to support first, and they want to try and help developers realize their vision properly. There's a shared goal there, and everyone, if we can work together, we can create some great things together.
Thank you. Okay, so as you all know, we announced the newest member of the PlayStation family earlier this year. And I look forward to updating you on Worldwide Studios activities on PlayStation 4 later. But first, I would like to invite our lead system architect to join us. As a result of Mark Cerny's focus on ease of access and ease of development as essential pillars of our next-gen vision, PlayStation 4 has been embraced by the development community. This, in turn, has resulted in an upsurge in creativity, promising much richer and diverse next-gen experiences for all our gamers. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark Cerny.
Thank you, Michael. So this February in New York, after a five-year development, we were finally able to reveal to the world our newest home console, the PlayStation 4. And we had a number of goals in mind when developing the hardware. We knew that performance would be critical, so we set our target at 10 times the performance of any previous console, and the result is a hardware that makes possible the stunning graphics and rich interactive worlds of the games that you're seeing today. PlayStation 4 is the world's most powerful game console. We also knew that to satisfy gamers, we'd need to bring the very best games to the platform. So during the development of the hardware, we toured the world, conversing in depth with game creators about what sort of feature set they would like to see in a next generation console. And this collaborative approach extended to the design of the controller as well, as we fine-tuned it in many ways, making it more accurate, more responsive, and a more ideal controller for first-person shooters. Through these close relationships with some of the best teams in the world, we've been able to architect a console that truly is by game creators for game creators, that combines very large processing power with remarkable ease of game development. And gamers will be thrilled by how some of the biggest names in the business are leveraging this accessibility to bring blockbuster games to the platform, such as Watch Dogs, Destiny, and Killzone. The result is the strongest launch lineup in PlayStation history. And our launch and launch window lineup shows great breadth and diversity because the supercharged PC architecture of the platform has eased development for smaller teams as well. It's both quicker to bring indie titles to PlayStation 4 and quicker to develop them on the platform. Indie brings us a vital dimension. Being the best place to play has always meant supporting a broad variety of game experiences, whether that be Parappa the Rapper on the original PlayStation or last year's Journey on PlayStation 3. As Adam Boy says, we want to provide gamers with an endless variety of beautiful, challenging, and fantastic experiences. And the passion of small teams is critical in transforming that goal into reality. We've been taking the launch of PlayStation 4 as an opportunity to elevate the presence and visibility of these indie teams still further. On the technology side, we now support Unity. On the business side, we fully support self-publishing across all platforms, so it's possible for developers to maintain complete creative and financial control. We're also supporting indie development financially in many ways through loaner dev kits, our incubation program, and from direct support from the Pub Fund. And of course, we've been reaching out to the most innovative teams as well, looking to ensure that their latest projects make their exclusive console debut on PlayStation platforms. As a consequence, we believe that a renaissance of gaming is coming on PlayStation 4. Heavy content will thrive on the platform, but in many ways will also be returning to the creative freedom and broad content that made the early years of PlayStation so unforgettable. And to tell you about a number of exciting titles making their debut on PlayStation platforms, please welcome Shahid Ahmad.
Thanks, Mark. So, Mark has been working closely with developers on the PS4's architecture. Meanwhile, an indie development revolution is happening. We've been listening to indies. We've asked them what it means to be an indie. Indie means freedom. Imagine the freedom to create what you want, the freedom to release when you want, and the freedom to choose the device that you want. Tonight, I want to show you a few examples of how, at PlayStation, we're working to become the place indies prefer to be. In this year's Indie Smash by Teddy and Kenny Lee, if you die, your not quite perfect children get to avenge you, or die trying. Our fans have told us loud and clear that they want this game on PlayStation. Who are we to disagree? So I'm pleased to announce that Rogue Legacy by Celador Games will make its console exclusive debut on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita next year. Edmund McMillan has made a career of pouring himself into twisted worlds. He's shared his full vision for Binding of Isaac Rebirth, and Nicholas are completely remaking this smash hit, adding a whole new game's worth of content. Binding of Isaac Rebirth will make its console-exclusive debut on PS4 and PS Vita next spring, and for PlayStation Plus customers, it will be available at no additional cost. Mare and Reagan, the tiny team at Metanet Software, have been working tirelessly on the final and definitive installment of their amazingly addictive N series. N++ will feature innovative new multiplayer modes, thousands of handcrafted levels, and the tools to create, share, and compete worldwide across endless levels of your own. N++ will debut exclusively on PS4 this winter. Now, the award-winning Thomas Was Alone catapulted Mike Bithell into global stardom. It also gave him the opportunity to devote his time and talent to continue making exactly what he wanted. Volume is a game about being heard, where you can create, remix, and share worlds. And we don't know quite where Mike's going with Volume, but that's the whole point. It's up to him. We're just proud that he's chosen PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita for Volume's world exclusive debut next year. Howard Sau and his team at Muse Games are ambitious. Pursuing their vision, refusing constraints, they've continued to evolve and refine their dream project, where you pilot a variety of majestic airships through the war-torn skies of a gritty steampunk universe. We're happy to announce that Guns of Icarus Online will make its console-exclusive debut on PlayStation 4. Now, if ever a developer was an indie icon, it's Vlambeer, creators of Super Crate Box, Ridiculous Fishing, and Luftrausers. JW and Rami sometimes sketch out ideas at game jams, and some of these ideas turn into fully developed games. Their latest is Wasteland Kings, which they describe as a roguelike-like, which I'm really excited to say is going to be making its console-exclusive debut on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita next year. And finally, Hotline Miami by Denison Games has been one of the outstanding success stories from the indie world. It blends a powerful story with razor-sharp action and one of the greatest soundtracks in video game history. We worked with Devolver and Denison to ensure that Hotline Miami was best on Vita. This freed Denison Games to focus on Hotline Miami 2 Wrong Number, which we're absolutely thrilled to say is going to be making its console exclusive debut on PlayStation 4 and, of course, PlayStation Vita next year. Now, these are just some of the great games coming first to PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita over the coming year. You know, at PlayStation, we make no secret of how much we love indie games or of how proud we are to work with some of the most talented and creative developers in the world. We want to bring their best ideas to PlayStation, the best place to play. And now I'd like to hand back to Michael Denny to update us on where Worldwide Studios are going to be taking the PS4. Thank you.
Thanks, Shahid, and thanks, Mark. PlayStation 4's architecture has underpinned our shared vision for a system designed for gamers, by gamers, so that no matter what the idea, big or small, as long as it's compelling and fun, PlayStation 4 will provide the perfect platform. And echoing the thoughts of the indie community, never before have our teams had so much freedom to bring such a wide variety of creative ideas to life. Worldwide Studios comprises 14 studios spanning three continents. Each of these studios has an essential role to play in our future, with all of them now working on PlayStation 4, including yet-to-be-announced titles from Santa Monica, Media Molecule, and Naughty Dog. We also have a large network of over 50 multi-talented external teams producing exclusive games for PlayStation platforms. And it's not just the quantity of new experience that's important to us, but also the wide geographical and cultural spread of content it brings. And over half of these teams are based here in Europe, where we are privileged to work with some of the best talent from the UK, France, Spain, Italy, Sweden, Finland, Netherlands, Poland, and here in Germany, allowing our games to experience a wide variety of cultural and gameplay influences from around Europe. As Shahid mentioned, the indie community has been a great inspiration to our teams at Worldwide Studios. We get a tremendous buzz when indies that have already demonstrated their amazing creativity to the world choose to work with us to produce exclusive content for PlayStation. And I'm pleased to say that one of those teams is the Chinese Room, an award-winning studio from the UK, already known for thought-provoking experiences that have a lasting impact on the player. So it's great to have the opportunity to introduce their latest work with this short trailer, Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. Thank you. The Chinese Room took us on an emotional journey with Dear Esther, and Everybody's Gone to the Rapture promises to be just as moving and intense. Next is a new game from the talented Spanish developer Tequila Works. Rime is an open-world adventure game which takes us on a voyage of discovery and danger as we're drawn into the mystery of a civilization once immensely powerful but inexplicably brought to ruin. Let's take a look at some early footage that shows the team's ambition. Thank you. Crossplay between platforms has proved a great feature for PlayStation gamers. So I'm pleased to announce a new cross-platform title called Helldivers from Arrowhead Studios, the talented Swedish team behind the indie mega hit Magicka. Teamwork is the key to survival in this cooperative squad-based shooter that will bring thrilling multiplayer action to PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3, and PlayStation Vita. Let's take a look. Thank you. Every PlayStation console has delivered great arcade shoot-em-ups, and PlayStation 4 will be no exception. Finnish-based developer Housemarque have proved their credentials in this genre, with the acclaimed Super Stardust being one of the graphical standout titles at launch of PlayStation 3. Their new title, Resogun, is a pure arcade action shooter for the next-generation gamer, with addictive, challenging gameplay and, of course, massive explosions to match. Thank you. Generations of gamers share our passion for playing great games from different eras. So I would now like to share our next-gen vision for an iconic Amiga game, fondly remembered for its best-in-class graphics, music, and unique art style. It's my pleasure to introduce Shadow of the Beast, reimagined for PlayStation 4. Okay, now let's take a brief look at some of the Worldwide Studios titles that we previously announced. At E3, some of you may have seen a demo we presented called The Playroom. It's a great example of how PlayStation 4 can support a variety of unique gameplay styles, and how the DualShock 4 and PlayStation Camera can work together to create innovative and fun new experiences. And to enable everyone to join in the fun, I'm pleased to confirm the Playroom will be pre-installed on every PlayStation 4 from launch. Let's take a look.
We've got a PS4 to play.
Do you want to be one of the first people in the world to play?
Since its announcement in New York earlier this year, Infamous Second Son from Sucker Punch has been exciting both gamers and the press alike, having already been nominated for over 20 awards. As the team continues to push the gameplay and visual boundaries of the Infamous franchise, I'm pleased to be able to share with you a new trailer showing the progress the title is making on its way to its PlayStation 4 debut.
Abigail Walker, but my friends and enemies call me Fetch. I've never hurt an innocent person in my life.
Hey, Reg, that conduit struck again. Gotta stroll through the security checkpoint first, and then I'll scope it out.
Best 2 out of 3.
Brother?
What happened?
Come on, get up.
I know
just where to put filth like this. She won't be hurting anybody else.
What do you think I'm doing to the DUP?
When it comes to conduits, it's my call. Not yours, not ours, mine. Meeting new people.
So we're super excited for all of our teams who are creating launch window titles for PlayStation 4, including Drive Club from Evolution Studios, Knack from Mark Cerny and our Japan studio, and The Order 1886 from Ready at Dawn, which was announced recently at E3 and will launch in 2014. And last, but by no means least, from the multi-award winning Guerrilla Studio in Amsterdam, Killzone Shadowfall, which promises to be a huge launch title for PlayStation 4. As you saw in the opening user interface demo, the game has a spectacular multiplayer mode. So just before I hand back to Jim, I would like to leave you with some new multiplayer footage of Killzone Shadowfall. Thank you. So 15 new PS4 games announced today, all of which are console exclusive to PS4 at their launch. At E3, we presented our plans for entertainment services on PS4. Over the past few years, we've come to understand that gamers really value being able to use their consoles to watch movies, use catch-up TV, and listen to music. It remains a fundamental part of our strategy to offer these services as a core component of our basic PlayStation Network service package, available to all and not placed behind a subscription gate. One such service coming to PS4 is Twitch, the world's leading video platform and community for gamers, which will allow you to enjoy live streaming of gameplay using the Spectate feature that you saw demonstrated by Shu at the start of the show. And as we're here in Europe, I wanted to take the opportunity to announce that we have over 20 video services and applications coming to PS4 in this region, and including for our German hosts, WatchEver and Maxdome. As we mentioned at E3, Sony's Music Unlimited service will be available on day one for PlayStation 4. I'm pleased to announce that we've enhanced Music Unlimited specifically for PS4 through a new interface that is faster, simpler, and better, enabling gamers to discover new artists and songs within the global catalog of 22 million tracks. In addition, we've added two new features that many PlayStation gamers have requested. First, the ability to listen to music in the background while playing games. And second, we're making it easier than ever to access Music Unlimited, even when you're not in the application. Just press the PS button on the DualShock 4 and a quick navigation bar will appear that enables you to skip and pause tracks and control the volume of the music.
Another area that we recognize as key to getting full enjoyment from the socially connected PS4 experience is broadband. Europe's a great place to live, but as all of us know, broadband can be an issue in many parts of the continent, with average consumer broadband speed around 5 megabits per second. In order to give gamers the best online gaming experience, PlayStation is entering into strategic partnerships with some of Europe's leading ISPs. And I'm pleased to announce tonight that the first partnerships will be with Deutsche Telekom, Orange, Virgin Media, and Ono. Our plan is to offer a range of broadband packages to PS4 gamers that include reserved parts of the pipe for gaming, broadband speeds of up to 200 megabits per second, and attractive PS4 and PlayStation Plus offerings. And I look forward to sharing more details about these partnerships as well as announcing additional partners in the coming weeks and months. Another of the ways in which we've worked really hard to provide value to gamers has been through PlayStation Plus and its Instant Game Collection, providing PlayStation gamers across PS3, PS4, and PS Vita with access to more than a dozen games a month, all of these games having a Metacritic of 80 or more. And when you add in the numerous services that also come with PlayStation Plus, the price of just over €4 a month clearly represents extraordinary value. And to ensure that all PS4 gamers have a chance to discover PlayStation Plus, we will offer a free 14-day trial to any new PS4 owner with full access to the Instant Game Collection, including for day one on PS4, Drive Club PS Plus Edition, and Resogun, one of the new PS4 games that Michael introduced earlier. One title that we're really excited to be bringing to PlayStation Plus for PS3 owners in September is from Europe's leading publisher, Ubisoft. That title is Assassin's Creed 3, and it joins a long list of blockbuster titles available on PlayStation Plus. And finally on PlayStation Plus, if you're thinking of signing up ahead of PS4, we have a great offer for European consumers. Starting tomorrow and lasting for a month, if you sign up for a year via the PlayStation Store, PlayStation will add an additional 90 days to your membership. I now want to spend some time talking about the lineup of third-party games that will be available at the launch of PS4. Bringing Assassin's Creed 3 to PlayStation Plus members is only one example of how the strength of our partnership with Ubisoft is benefiting the PlayStation gamer. We're now going to focus on the blockbuster games from Ubisoft that will be there at launch and demonstrate the reasons why these games work best on PlayStation. First of all, a demonstration of Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag, which will not only show a stunning new level of the game, but will also demonstrate the remote play feature, which allows a PS4 game to be played remotely on a PS Vita via Wi-Fi. The first part of the demo will show the game on PS4. What you'll then see is the game being played on PS Vita using remote play. Now, an in-home illustration of this would be gamer in the lounge playing Black Flag on PS4. Partner comes into the lounge and wants to watch some rubbish on television. So gamer has to go to the bedroom in a sulk and carries on with Black Flag using remote play on the PS Vita in complete peace and quiet. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Carl and Pascal to give a live demonstration of Assassin's Creed and remote play on PS4.
Thank you, Jim. It's a pleasure to be here tonight and share with you our Gamescom demo of Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. Let's get into the action.
So, what'll you do with your share of the gold we take from Governor Torres? Return to Africa, prince among men.
I cannot return to a place I've never been. I was born in Trinidad, a slave from my first breath.
Yeah. But wouldn't you feel, I don't know, more welcome there?
As you might feel more welcome in Paris.
Fair point.
With this skin and this voice, where can I go in the world and feel at ease? This country here is my best chance. This country called Jackdaw. where I know the names of all citizens and they know mine, and we work together. Not always out of love, but to keep our country afloat.
I think I understand you. Let's take her then.
For the citizens of Jackdaw.
Into the wind! Get those spars free! Let me that dock!
Fire! Put a shot right through there!
Mortar incoming!
So now someone else wants to use the television, using Remote Play and his PlayStation Vita. Pascal will now take over the rest of the demo.
Hello, Your Excellency. I'd got word you might be here.
I know your face, pirate, but your name was borrowed the last time we spoke.
Ah, yes, I recall. I missed that one. So, what's a Templar Grand Master doing so far from his Castillo?
I'd rather not say.
And I'd rather not cut your lips off and feed them to you.
Thank you, Pascal. Thank you, everyone. This demo is available to play hands-on on both the Ubisoft and Sony booths, so we hope to see most of you there over the week. Have a great Gamescom.
Doesn't the game look great? And I'm pleased to say that you will be able to play almost all PS4 games on your PS Vita using remote play via Wi-Fi in the way that was just demonstrated. A really great example of the power of the PlayStation ecosystem. Assassin's Creed is a franchise that has been associated with PlayStation for many years now, and we're really pleased to continue our partnership with Ubisoft in 2013. I'd like to show a short video focusing on the level of the game that will be exclusive to both PS3 and PS4 at launch.
It has been 5 long years that I've searched for a cause to fight for. I've crossed this world and still have been met with the same painful truth. There are those who take, and those who suffer. I realize now that freedom from such tyranny can only be achieved at the edge of a blade. This is my cause. This is why I must keep fighting.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome onto the stage to talk about his games and about the launch of the PS4, the co-founder and CEO of Ubisoft, Yves Guillemot.
Jim.
Yves, lots of people here tonight. Gamescom's come a long way since the old days at Leipzig.
Yeah, actually, when we will see this show this year, it's amazing compared with what we had a few years ago.
And Yves, you've been bugging me for about 3 years now about next gen. And when I look at Black Flag, I can see why. You still excited?
I'm extremely excited because Assassin's Creed this year will probably be the best and biggest we have ever done. So I think it will show what the PS4 can do.
Now, you guys at Ubisoft have a terrific track record of bringing new IP at the time of platform launch. And it looks like this time around isn't going to be any different.
Yeah, the Watch Dogs game is going to be, I think, the best game of the show, probably. So I think you will see something in a few minutes that will tell you more about what it is, and it's really next gen.
And you have some more news to share with us about Watch Dogs.
Yes, I came today for very important news. In fact, we are partnering with Sony to create a blockbuster movie on Watch Dogs. So I think this will be very important for the industry, as those two companies that we are have been doing games. So the next movies will probably be different. And in 20 years when we meet, we'll speak about that again to see what those two games and movies did to change the world.
Yves, thank you so much for taking the time to be with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for Yves Guillemot. And now, Watch Dogs on PS4.
CTOS's groundbreaking technology. We're promoting efficiency, comfort, and safety, dedicated to protecting you and your family.
Citizens of Chicago, we are DedSec. You have heard enough lies. It is time to hear the truth. You can be hacked. Someone is inside the network. We have seen him.
You wanted the system hacks?
You got me in.
He is not DedSec, and we do not defend him.
Police believe they are closing in on suspected vigilante Aiden Pierce.
Suspect is in a vehicle and attempting to flee.
He is proof.
Squad, we're on the scene and in pursuit.
That the CTOS network is flawed.
Jesus Christ!
And you are vulnerable. One man has done exactly what we have warned you about.
Are you in trouble?
No, I'm not.
The virus is still doing damage. Shut it down!
Now is the time to wake up.
So the level that you just saw is exclusive to PlayStation at launch. Now for something a little different. And one title that we're extremely happy to announce as part of our launch lineup for PS4 is... Minecraft. And another launch title coming from our third-party partners is a PS4 console exclusive from Gaijin, War Thunder. War Thunder is a free-to-play next-gen combat game dedicated to major World War II battles. It includes aerial, ground, and naval multiplayer combat in the gaming experience. Let's take a look. There are simply too many PS4 titles available before Christmas for me to be able to talk about each one. But as you can see, the lineup is stronger than we've had for any other platform introduction. So this is a hugely exciting time for everyone in our industry, and a great moment for me to hand over to my boss, the president and CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment, Andrew House, to give you his thoughts and to bring the show to a close.
Thank you, Jim. It's a real pleasure to be back at Gamescom and amidst lots of great momentum for PlayStation. The arrival of PlayStation 4 presents an opportunity to transform the gameplay experience into something far more engaging and social. But the launch of PS4 is only one piece of that puzzle. PS3 continues to grow in strength, particularly here in Europe, where it has market leadership in the majority of countries. And what better way to make PS3 the preferred entry point into PlayStation than to ensure that the price point is accessible? I'm happy to announce that within the SCE region, we are reducing the RRP of the 12-gigabyte PlayStation 3 to €199. And in North America, I'm also pleased to confirm that the 12-gigabyte PS3 will be released with an RRP of $199. Thank you. And there's some more exciting news. For those millions of PS3 owners, deciding whether to buy the PS3 or PS4 version of Call of Duty Ghosts from Activision, Watch Dogs and Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag from Ubisoft, and Battlefield 4 from EA, I am delighted to confirm that when those games launch on PS4, gamers who have already bought the PS3 version will, for a limited period, be able to buy the digital PS4 versions for a significantly discounted price. We see this as a great way to reward PS3 gamers for their loyalty when transitioning to PS4, ensuring that it is as simple and accessible as possible. Activision, Ubisoft, EA, and Warner Brothers are the first publishers to commit to this. And over the coming weeks and months, we look forward to sharing more information with you. With PS Vita, we firmly believe that alongside the vast array of content coming to the platform and the relationship between PlayStation Vita and PS4, it'll prove to be irresistible, with all PS4 games being playable on PS Vita via remote play, all for an RRP of €199 and $199. We see a new and bright chapter in the life of PlayStation Vita. But above all, 2013 is the year when interactive entertainment takes a major leap forward with the launch of PS4. Our goals for PS4 are clear, ambitious, and unwavering. We set out to build the most powerful gaming platform with a deeply held, consistent focus on you, the gamer. We sought insight from the best developers in the world to create a platform that would allow them to build the games that they're inspired to create. We built a system of unprecedented power to answer their needs and bring new experiences to the world's gamers. PS4 embraces our always connected world through companion apps and accessibility from tablets and smartphones. This means that great game worlds will be more ubiquitous, powerful, and accessible than ever before. And while others have shifted their message and changed their story, we were consistent in maintaining policies and a model that is fair and in tune with consumer desires. We strove to deliver a platform that offers the consumer both innovation and great value. And it's with the gamer in mind that when PS4 launches in Europe and the US, it will launch with a price of €399, $399, and £349. The response that we have received has been nothing short of incredible. You've made it clear that you're excited about this platform, with more than 1 million pre-orders already worldwide. And before I leave, I've one last announcement to make. I'm delighted to say that PlayStation 4 will be launching in 32 countries in total during this holiday season, and will become available in North America on the 15th of November and in Europe from the 29th of November. Thank you all very much for your time this evening. Please enjoy the rest of Gamescom. Thank you and good night.
We wanted to bring in that social nature to, you know, the our UI on PS4. Every time, you know, they boot up PS4, the latest information is there. Just, you know, booting up and checking what their friends are doing or what the latest from the publisher, that's always going to be a, you know, pleasant experience for players.
Abigail Walker, but my friends and enemies call me Fetch. I've never hurt an innocent person in my life.
Hey, Reg, that conduit struck again. Gotta stroll through the security checkpoint first, and then I'll scope it out.
That's 2 out of 3.
Brother?
What happened?
Come on, get up, get up. I know just where to put filth like this. She won't be hurting anybody else.
What do you think I'm doing to the DUP?
When it comes to conduits, it's my call. Not yours, not ours, mine.
Meeting new people.